So I don't know. I'm actually not trying to show off or impress or anything, but it is performing as I expected. This is my trading technique, the profit only. Now, obviously, there are losses, and when those occur, those are just like dud stocks that you've purchased along the way. They're gonna dip into where your average gain is. So right now this is just December. This is 1 month. And this was really a great month because I had enough in my account. Bills are steepling high in the 3,000 range or whatever. It's difficult to trade when you have to keep pushing that off to pay all the bills. When you're looking at it in itself, it's kind of complementary because it's always saying you're gaining, you're gaining, you're gaining. There's no losses, but there are losses. There are a few months, and I try personally to only have 1 month out of the year as a dedicated loss allowed. So that's when I just say, okay, those ones I'm just getting rid of, and I'm going to look, my stats are going to look terrible that month. And yes, it affects the whole year. So because of my losses, my duds, in reality, my entire year was only about a 1.5, which that's the gain per trade. Now, you're looking also here at this. Now, okay, so now with this, it's saying 89. So out of 89 trades, those are the hello time brain. Yeah, sorry, the 89 of those. But obviously, if there was a loss in there, that would be in there as well. But, so with profit only, you're only ever going to see, 11 months out of the year, you're only going to see something like this for a month. You'll only see like 89 gaining trades. And it's just all good for your ego, because this is such a, I don't know, such a mean life anyway. Trying to scramble and with who you are here and who you are there. In somebody else's eyes, that you end up being, I don't know, partitioned as a half person the majority of the time. So here we are as this is an ego booster, profit only methodology. It's really what it's all about. Okay, so I'm gonna go into the hard facts, which are a little bit funner to look at. And so this last month, I actually churned out 733 dollars, and that's amazing. That's amazing, for my small account, that I made that much. So I'm pretty happy with that. Now, can I sustain that? Yes, I believe so. The only drama is if the account starts to dwindle away to pay bills. Because when your account starts dwindling away to pay the bills, because your mortgage, or you had this, or the roof repair, that type of thing, which I have had, believe it or not, I've had to repair a roof, and nobody paid for it except me. So those types of things that occur obviously are gonna chip away at your potential. So if you only have 20,000 that you're trading, or you only have 10,000 you're trading, or only have 30,000 that you're trading, it's all chipping away at your potential as soon as you start draining that account out to pay those bills. Anyway, so and so this was it, is you get that happy glorification of yes, And it's not just this. This is actually just a back room with the bank, but where you can find this type of thing, the P&L gain loss ratios. But in real drama, on a daily, it's where you're looking at it on the platform. It's when you go and you look at it, say, okay, what happened today? My buys and sells, this is it. When you see it all green, it's another thing to make you feel just, like, hey, I'm still heading in the right direction. And how can I improve upon it, of course? Because I would like to make, $1,000 a month. I would like to, make more. And obviously, if I'm able to feed more money into the account, then I can make more trading. It's just the way this particular method works. And you keep your losses down. And remember, I'm trading from a kitty of up to 40 stocks. And that they can be anything. They can be retail, they can be tech, mix them up. Have a little bit of everything. I'm a little heavy in tech, and I have started to add silly things. Like I even added Walmart, and then I got really mad at Walmart after I entered into Walmart, because now they're doing like breast exams right there in the store, and they're gonna give women lumpectomies or something. So I got really mad at them, and I just wanted to sell their stock right away, but I wasn't allowed to because I was gonna trade it for money instead of just getting out. So I had to hold on to their blasted stock after that news. But yeah, they really angered me. But they're actually at a pretty low. If you're into, clipping off women's breasts, I don't know. That's your deal. I just think that was a really bad move of them to be getting involved in that. Okay, so anyway. That was it. That was it. So this is my and with profit only trade, you should do this technique like I'm doing right now. Going, okay, I made my 90 exits. And they were 90 gains, and so I'm feeling pretty great. And so keep track of that. So it sets me on, like, I'm about a 1200 a year or so. It sets me on that track of how many trades, because you have to keep up with your taxes, and Tax Act does have the 2000 allow. I believe one of those other ones, TurboTax, maybe has a lot allow, but it's also like $150. Tax Act though is not easy, because last times I've used it, it's always a CSV import, and the CSV, the headers do not match with Tax Act, and so it's kind of not an easy electronic automatic. There's nothing automatic about it. It kind of puts you through the paces, even though it is still dragging all of the data in one CSV. It's still putting you through the paces of figuring out what the headers are, and that can take up to 2 hours, 3 hours sometimes. So I'm really kind of upset at that. And I actually wrote to Schwab, and I said, are you going to fix that? Are you going to make the headers match? Or I don't think they will. I don't think they will, even though they were seamless with TD Ameritrade. Tax Act was an automatic, no CSV version style. So I guess the TD Ameritrade traders that are using Tax Act will find that out and go, oh my gosh, what is this? Because you don't want to pay an extra $50 if you don't have to file taxes. I'm already paying like $90, I think, because I have to file some kind of a self-employment gigger type of thing. So because I have to do that, it just keeps racking up the bill. And I rented a room once, and that racks up the tax bill on the company, the company that I am, you know. So yeah. Anyway, so that was all I was doing today. Was just I was trying to tell you to do this, as you know, you do it once a month. But right now it's really the end of the year, so it's more exciting in a way. And had I had this going every single month, I would be pretty darn happy with my trading as a gain, as I'd be pretty happy with what it was collecting. But because of bills, I haven't been able to build to this yet, and so it's taken me a time this long to have enough money in my account to actually make enough out of the trading. So anyway, that's it. That's all I have for today. And oh yeah, be careful with dividends. Some of those dividend stocks, you can use a dividend calendar that is present at tip ranks, and it's really nice, and it and you don't even have to sign on. It does feed you out a few, but the ones that I was fed, I entered into those, and I didn't do enough legwork on them. And then I found out that, oh my gosh, they're dying stocks. And so now I bought into dying stocks, and that are paying great dividends. So I'm kind of upset on those particular trade entries. So always go back in the charts, do a daily back 3 years, find out, you know, what is going on with this company. And I was just being negligent. I was going with what the analysts were saying. The analysts were giving it a moderate buy, and everything was all happy. And then I'm like, oh crud, it's at a real low. So even though it's going to feed out 14% dividend, or 15%, yeah, be careful. And so don't overinvest in those. Because of that, it's almost like they got their company, and then they're just having it fizzle off into the wind. I don't understand it, but so now I'm thinking I have to exit those sooner than later. Anyway, so that's the track that I'm on with profit only, and it is about the ego, you know. It's about the ego build, because trading is a real damner when the market reverses. And right now we're having a great buoyant market, aren't we? We're having a great buoyant market. It's going steeply high in a lot of things. You saw Apple; it went from 177. It's in the 190s. You know, all of these are just really great. Is it going to continue? You know, we don't know this exact answer. You can only make predictions or try. And that's kind of up to you to make on your own charts and everything. I can't make those predictions for you. Anything else? Yeah, so like I was saying, so all in all, my average gain per trade ends up being about, oh, and that's another thing at the tip rank site. When you're looking at analysts, one analyst might say his average gain is 1.5, and another's over there saying 8.5. That just has to do with how long they've held that trade. Remember, you know, how often they trade. So the 8.5 guy maybe only trades 40 trades a month, and the 1.5 guy trades 150, so you can have that disparity. And yet when you count all of his 1.5s up together, they equal the 8.5 guy. So take those numbers with a grain of salt, because it's really about the per trade and how many trades. And in this instance, I'm 90 approximate. All right, and that's it for today. I'm signing off. I have a happy meet and greet showing up. All right.